This video shows how to create railings in ARCHICAD using various methods. ARCHICAD 21's new railing tool is the first associative 3D tool, which means that it can be associated to certain other construction element types when placed. And its geometry is automatically updated when the host element's geometry is changed. A railing is placed using the polyline input method. A railing polyline has nodes, and segments between nodes. The railing tools info box contains two panels that control associativity. The railing and node associativity panel controls whether railing nodes will be associated to clicked construction element nodes. If it is set to the static option, the railing node will not be associated to the clicked node of the other element. Thus, if the other element's geometry is modified, it does not affect the railing's geometry in any way. If it's set to the associative option, the railing node will be associated to the clicked node of the other element. Therefore, if we move the corresponding node of the host element, the railing node will also move as dictated by this associativity. The Segment Associativity panel controls whether railing segments will be associated to corresponding segments of the railing's host element. With the associative option, when the host element's corresponding segment is modified, the railing segment is also modified accordingly. When railing and node associativity is set to static, segment associativity will also be set automatically to the static value by ARCHICAD. When railing and node associativity is set to associative, segment associativity may either be static or associative. When placing stairs, you can use the info box to place associative railings along with the stair. Prior to placement, click the Place Left Railing or Place Right Railing buttons to place the railing along the left or right side stair boundary, respectively. When the stair is created, associative railings will also be created along with it, and their nodes and segments will all be associated to their respective stair boundary polyline nodes and segments. When placing railings associated to polygonal element types, such as slabs, click one slab node. Then hover your cursor over another slab node. Graphical feedback indicates that the railing can be created along slab segments between the two points clockwise or counterclockwise. You can press the Tab key on your keyboard to switch between the two options. This example shows that during railing polyline input, you do not have to click every single slab node. Instead, you can just specify the starting and end nodes of the railing element. In such cases, ARCHICAD will create automatic associative nodes at intermediate nodes of the host element. Hotspots help in the identification of railing node types. User-created associative railing nodes have round dot-shaped hotspots. User-created static railing nodes have square-shaped hotspots. Associative railing nodes created automatically by ARCHICAD do not have hotspots. Railing nodes can only be associated to host nodes, but not to general points on a host polygon segment, such as the middle point of a slab segment. If you do not click on a node during input, the created railing node will be static as indicated by the shape of its hotspot. Railings may be created in the 3D viewpoint as well. You can click the nodes of walls, slabs, roofs, meshes, or stairs to place an associated railing just like in the floor plan viewpoint. When the host element is moved, or its geometry is modified, the railing is also updated based on the new geometry and position of its host element. Railings may also be created using the magic wand. For details, please watch the previous clip in this playlist titled Railing Tool, Creating Railings with the Magic Wand.